you. Thank you very much. That was a song that was written by Ray Noble. I don't know exactly when it was Ray Noble wrote that song, but it's on the title of the first CD that I did called The Very Thought of You, back in 95. I think the only one person missing from that CD is Paul Langosh, was on bass, and Rick Harris, Bill's brother, was on trumpet. This next song was written by Irving Berlin, and it's again from Fred Astaire, Ginger Rogers movie. I think, if I recall the movie, Fred has seen Ginger dance with somebody else and he wants to dance with her, so he cozies up to her and he sings a song to her. Embrace with you, the movie too.
Embrace me, my sweet impressible you. Embrace me, you irrepressible you. Considerably younger
so we sat and we watched the movie April Love on video. And I took the video so he could, maybe I could catch a, you know, his eye and say, hey. And he came to that part of the show where he sings that song, April Love, and he says, I usually sing this song to somebody in the audience. So he spotted this young lady up there. And there were only two ladies in the whole place. And he came over to her and he said, I want to sing this song to you. And I said, you know, I got the video. And he said, people have brought me pictures, they've brought me records, but they've never brought me videos. So he signed the video and he sang it to her. But the fact that there were only four people there allowed me later on to sit down and have dinner with him and ask him about every single actress I've ever been with. I said, what happened to this lady in this movie? And he said, oh, she's fat, married a French guy. Because so remember all of his movies, his leading ladies are not around anymore. Christine Carrier, I think, was a lady in Mardi Gras, and I asked her about her, and he told me that she was in France. Anyway, I just ate up 5 minutes, which is good. Anyway, this song is just Might As Well Be Spring. Pat Boone doesn't sing this in the movie. It's sung by an actress named Pamela Tiffin at the beginning of the movie. Her love interest is Bobby Darin. Remember Bobby Darin?
Jumping as a puppet on
anybody who can raise their hand and tell me what the name of that song is, I'll give them the CD that that song came from. God, see, nobody knows the name of that song. It's called It Might As Well Be Spring. That came from a CD that I recorded last year called Tenderly, which is a tribute to Felix Grant, a local disc jockey that was here for 30-odd years. He died in 1993. And we dedicated the whole album to him, and I spoke to his widow about songs that he had played frequently over the 30-year span. He finished up at WDCU 90.1 FM, which I understand might not be playing jazz very much longer, but we're hoping that whoever buys the station will keep the format, because a lot of musicians like myself locally here don't get to have our music played in a lot of the other stations. So if any of you out there have influence or whatever, call them and let them know that you still want to hear jazz in Washington. Andre Lacerda, who is from 90.1, is going to be here and talk to you about Jobim during the second part of this show. But anyway, the name of the CD is called Tenderly, and as Paul Ballenbach once said, you can buy my CDs at Tower Records, but I won't be there to sign them. I learned from that experience. I brought some CDs if you later want to pick some up. Well, this is for my Spanish CD. It's called Yo Te Recuerdo, the Spanish CD. And the song is called Magic Use of Moonlight, which was recorded in 1950-something by Dean Martin and now called Dino Latino with the English version. We're going to end this session, and I understand there's a wine reception afterwards, and for those of you who'd like to come back, we have a second set where we're gonna do mostly, not mostly, but a good part of it will feature Paul on the acoustic guitar and myself doing some Antonio Carlos Jobim tunes. Jobim is the composer of Girlfriend Panima, but he wrote so many other different tunes that we're gonna sing for you with the rest of the band as well. We're gonna end this with a Richard Adler, Jerry Ross song. I'm gonna tell the band that I wanted to sing it in what's called medium bossa. That'll set the tempo. They're searching for the music. Searching for the charts, the chord symbols. You get it. This is a song that I stole from an old Tony Gil album called The Very Thought of You. It's actually written by, but I would say introduced by John Raitt. Anybody remember John Raitt? Good thing I didn't say he could get a CD of that. Tell him right here. Bonnie's father, John Raitt, who sang in another totally different genre. He was a tenor, very well-known tenor, Broadway, Pajama Game. He introduced the song in the Pajama Game, I believe. Am I right? And he actually just recorded it with his daughter again. She recorded with him a lot of his old tunes. He did also Annie Get Your Gun, I think, and he sang They Say It's Wonderful. This one's Hey There.
She's got you, Jack.